Did you know you can actually take a Camtasia video and make it trackable on your learning management system with very little effort? And you can even add quizzes throughout your video and have the learner interact with those quizzes that will also be tracked over to your learning management system. That's a lot. Not everybody does that inside of Camtasia, but we're going to cover that feature today. Welcome back. My name is Jeff Batt, and if you haven't checked out my website already, go ahead and check out my website at learningdojo.ninja. Here you can check out all previous blog posts, including everything on XAPI and Camtasia and Storyline and all those different types of topics. You can also download templates, and these include Storyline templates, as well as XAPI and video templates, and in the future, Camtasia templates as well that you can download from here. And you can also check out full courses on Articulate Storyline 360, Adobe Captivate, XAPI Fundamentals, Articulate Rise, Custom SCORM, HTML5 video, and more. I am currently working on a Camtasia Fundamentals, everything from A to Z course as well. So make sure you come back and check that out. But today we're going to talk about a feature inside of Camtasia that you may or may not have actually used, and how to add quiz questions to your Camtasia project, and also how to add tracking to your Camtasia project. So I'm going to go ahead and pull up a Camtasia project that I've already built. This is a video that I basically created on how to, one of my blog post videos on how to use Zapier. And so what I'm going to do here is I'm going to insert different quiz questions throughout the video. You may want to have tracking that will report over to a learning management system. If you're not familiar with a learning management system allows you to track learners and make course assignments and create reports on what the learning is or what the person has done. And so it allows you to do all of that inside of one system. And so Camtasia not only creates awesome screen recordings and different animations, which you can check out more videos here, but it also allows you to create trackable quizzes inside of the learning management system. And so you have to figure that out. I haven't edited this video, so I'm just going to insert this at different points of the video. But you come into the video, and I'm going to zoom in a little bit. But there's this little drop down right here that if you select it, it has two different things. It has a marker and it has a quiz. Now the marker allows you to add chapter titles and everything, which I have a video over here as well if you wanted to learn how to do that. But the one I want to cover today is the quiz. Now this gives me a line that if I hover over this at any point in the video, I can pop a quiz question up. So you can see right here, quiz placeholder, the quiz will appear at this point in the video. To preview this, and this is going to be at 30 seconds basically, to preview this, click preview button in the quizzing tab. So I'm going to go ahead and come over here on the right hand side. Now I'm going to select from this drop-down box, and there's four different types of quiz questions that I can add. There's a multiple choice where they have different options. They have a fill in the blank where they actually have to type something in. A short answer gives me a little bit more answer besides just one word like the fill in the blank. And then there's a true or false, which basically yes or no, true or false. That's basically what that question is. And all this gets reported over through SCORM when you publish it out. So I want to do multiple choice, and this is the default question. And let's just say, what color is the sky? Basic answer, but I'm just going to say blue, red, and then I can add the possible answers over here. And so green, and you can add, I haven't tried a limit, but there might be a limit there. And then you just select over on the left-hand side which one is correct. You can also use the arrow buttons up and down to move this around here as well. Now, do I want to actually display feedback? If correct, you can display feedback there. If incorrect, display feedback there. Now, here is the most powerful part of this, and I think this is to make it interactive. You can actually go in and jump to a URL. You can continue the video after they answer the question, or if they get it incorrect, you can jump back to a certain time in the video. So I can actually specify by minutes and seconds and I think that might be milliseconds or something. You can specify what point in the video do you want to jump back to if they get it incorrect and have them review. That's pretty cool right there, but I'm going to go ahead and just say continue for now. And I'm going to uncheck where it says display. Now, do I want to ask more than one question at this point? If I do, I can go ahead and click on add question. And it's going to allow me to ask a couple questions at this point. Let's say I just want to ask one. So I'm going to go ahead and just move. And where it says quiz one question, that lets me know what that question is. And if I want to change the label to say quiz, like pre-quiz or something like that, quiz test or something like that, score quiz, this will make sure that it reports over to the learning management system. Viewer can see their results as well. So at the end, they can see the percentage, what if they got it right or wrong as well. And then this is where I can preview it. What is this going to look like? So this is where the question will pop up. Not the video, but the question, and I can see exactly what the question is going to be. So I'm going to click on hide, play the video, that's where the video is, and show quiz, and so forth. We'll get the full experience when we publish this out here in a second, but that's how I go in and add a question. Now, if I add a different type of question, let's go ahead and add a fill-in-the-blank question. This is where I'm looking for a specific answer. Just to use that same question that we were doing before, the color, not capital, but the color of the sky is, and then you would add like an underline or something. And then this is where you would type in the possible acceptable answers. You'll accept blue, you'll accept capital blue, and so forth, or gray if you wanted to get a little bit more detail, just all the different possible answers here. Now, do you want to display feedback? Can you still have those actions at the end of it here as well? And do you want to add more questions? Let's go ahead and add one more question, and we're going to do short answer. Now, you'll notice that you don't have any possible way to have any correct or incorrect options here because this is more like an essay question where you're getting their feedback. Now, it's not tracking this one because it can't track this one, but it's sending it over to the learning management system, and you can capture that data at that point. Just something important to keep in mind, and let's go ahead and preview that, and you can see the sky is blue. And let me type in blue here. And then I'm gonna say next. And then this is where you can see the person can expand it and they can type out their feedback during the video and then submit answer and so forth. All right, that is the final one is basically true or false where you just basically select true or false. When you preview this one, it's basically not gonna give you any other option besides true or false. So it's as simple as that to create the quiz question, but it's pretty powerful, especially that jump to point where you can jump to certain parts of the video. I think that's cool because if the learner already knows the answer, why not allow them to jump forward and skip certain parts of the video and stuff? So something to keep in mind. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and click on export. And in this case, we're gonna export out to a local file. Now, this is where by default, you probably won't see export as a web page. But if you click on export as a web page, there are a couple different options here. You can change the aspect ratio if you wanted to, but there is also this include quiz if you wanted to include the quiz and quiz report quiz results through email. So even if you don't have a learning management system, it will generate an email with the quiz results and you can allow the person to specify to who it actually goes to there. And then viewer identity, allow viewers to take quiz anonymously or require users to input their name and email and allow viewers to skip the question if you wanted to. And then also the appearance to take quiz now, view answers and so forth. I'm gonna skip back to here. We're not gonna report this through email. We're actually gonna report this through a learning management system, which this is SCORM. SCORM is how a course communicates to the learning management system. And so let's click on option here. Now this is the ID. If your LMS handles unique IDs, you can define that here. This is what the title will look like inside of the learning management system. This is the description of when somebody is about to launch the course. This is what the description will be. You can actually fill that out in most LMSs as well. What the subject is, if you want to publish it to SCORM 2004. So in this case, I would do that. Now, I would love if TechSmith actually enabled XAPI or CMI5 or something like that, because then holy cow, that opens up a whole lot more tracking capabilities. And this is my feature request. And if I can actually send over statements at different point in the video. So instead of adding a quiz, maybe I can send over like completed halfway in the video or completed the entire video or started. Holy cow, how much tracking could I get in the video if Camtasia enabled that? So that would be awesome. Now, language, duration as well, and then passing score. So they need to have an 80% view pass requirement. So this will basically say completion requirement. So there's like, okay, what passing is and what completion is. There's two different things. And then produce a zipped file. So I'm going to go ahead and click OK here and then click on export. Now, this will export it to a learning management system. I have a test learning management system, and this is cloud.scorm.com. You can sign up for a free account here. This is where I do most of my SCORM testing as well. So I can come in here and import a SCORM package and click on browse to go find that package. Now, I don't think that's finished yet, so I'll go ahead and pause the video and make sure that this finishes. All right, so it looks like it's finished. I'm gonna go ahead and take this zip file, which it did not zip for me. Let me actually make sure that it's published. Oh, didn't look like it included SCORM, so let's click on that produce zip file. I'm gonna do this one more time and click on replace. Let's go ahead and wait for that. All right, so this has been published. So let's go ahead and check this out now. So there's our zipped file. We can go ahead and upload that. I'm just moving it to my desktop here. Let's go ahead and upload this to SCORM Cloud. And let's test this out inside of SCORM Cloud and see how this works. Now, it should send over a completion when the video finishes, but I mostly want to see how the quiz is actually being reported over, and we can take a look at that. Okay, so it is finished. I'm going to go ahead and click on launch here. Now, depending on your learning management system, it will usually pop open a different screen or something like that, or it could show in the window. But most learning management systems handle SCORM 2004 1.2, so you may want to ask about that. But here's my video. There is also a complete video, but you'll notice these little points that will, I'm gonna skip to this, but this is where the question will pop up. And so I have this option of take quiz now. Now, these are my questions, so I can say read, submit answer, and you can see if it's correct or incorrect, but I'm gonna hit continue, and then it's going to jump up and take quiz now. And so that's really what happens is it's like it pauses the video, you take the quiz, and then you can continue from there. That is an option that I wanted to at least show you how to do inside of Camtasia that you can add. And then what will happen is the information gets reported over to your learning management system. So in this case, I can go ahead and look at these debug logs. I mean, I won't go through each of the details here, but this is the SCORM data that gets sent over. And then when the completion happens, so you can see all that data. Most LMSs make the reporting a lot easier for you or a lot nicer for you. So you can just run the report there. But Camtasia does allow you to export out SCORM. It does allow you to add quiz questions. It does allow you to jump to different points in the video as well. So a pretty cool application there. I also have an interactive video template you can check out, which you can also check out the video here on how to build that. That does also send over XAPI statements. So if you wanna learn how to do that or track XAPI statements, you can check that out. Also, if you like this video, go ahead and go to my YouTube channel and hit like and subscribe, and you'll be notified of all future videos that come out, and so you can get the latest and greatest with XAPI, Storyline, Camtasia as well. And don't forget to check out my website, my blog post, and you can see all my previous blog posts there. You can see all of my different templates, my courses on Articulate Storyline 360, Adobe Captivate, XAPI Fundamentals, Articulate Rise, Custom SCORM, HTML5 Video, and Camtasia to come here. That's it, and I'll see you in the next video. Thanks, everyone.